I'm Kieran the Barber, and today I'm going to be showing you how to cut and style a skin faded pompadour with a side part and a hard line. Well, hi guys, welcome to my second or third tutorial video now. So what we're going to be doing, we're going to start off, we're going to be doing a skin faded pompadour with a side part and a hard line put in. So what we're going to do, I'm going to take my Andis Masters, and I'm going to put them down. I've zero gapped them, so they're quite short. I'm going to take it just to the ear line, just because you don't want to go too high. What we're going to do is we're going to just as you come up to the end of the hair, literally just flick ever so slightly, because what that does is if you go up to a zero and you go all the way up, you don't give yourself any blend at all. It would just be like a step almost. So giving it that flick just helps with that blending ever so slightly. I'll take the blend just to the eyebrow. So then you've got enough room to blend. Then when you come around the ear, what you do is you take from here to here. So you were taking that part there just off. So you don't want to come all the way up and then step down. You want to come in a smooth motion. So you want to come almost as like you're going round the ear. So what I'll do is I'll pull the ear down slightly. You want to give it that slight curve coming round. You don't want it to be dense. So you want to give it a curve just coming round them edges slightly. I'm going to go over with a number one on the Andis Masters grades. These are magnetic grades. They stick on. You can't really pull them off. They're brilliant. They're a lot more safer as well. About half an inch to an inch just with the number one. Flicking up, bringing your comb into it, flicking up, bringing your comb into it. Once you get the hang of fading, it does get easier. It takes a long time to learn how to fade, but once you get there, it is so much easier. Right, so now what I'm going to be doing with my Masters, I'm going to be using the 0.5, and I'm literally going to be flicking this out, literally in the C motion, just flicking the zero and the one, just to try and blend them in together. Nice and slowly, you don't want to go too fast, but you don't want to take it too high. So always use that C motion, don't go in like that. Come in, come out, like the letter C. So what that'll do is I'll take just the edges off. You might not even hear anything come off, but as long as it starts to come off, then you've got it made, it's perfect.
How long did it take you to get the routine of fading?
A couple of years. I'd definitely say a couple of years. You learn all the old stuff first. Skin fading, to be fair, it's taken me years to learn how to skin fade. We never used to start off on skin. We used to think zero was a skin fade, but now, I mean, you can literally go bold, like a baby's bum bold. So it's different. It's changed the way the game is. You have to learn how to blend. A zero into a half is easy to blend. Mm. Well, it's easier to blend. But then when you start going from skin to hair, that's a completely different ball game. That's when you go, right, I'm going to have to get different tools, and I'm going to have to use different items and stuff like that. So yeah, it takes a while to learn. Pro combing, I'm going to be using my wool super tape cordless. I just like sometimes to flick from clipper to clipper. You notice there's two different Andis combs. There's a white one. You can buy a white one and a black one. And it's not just for color reference. You just go, oh, I like the white one or I like the black one. I use my white comb on darker hair for fading, because when you can come up with a white comb, you can clearly see the darker hair in it. So I'm gonna get my black comb out. And when you use the dark comb, it's not so noticeable. It's a bit harder to blend. So I just find it easier white comb on dark hair and black comb on sort of greyish hair or light hair, even gingerish hair, blonde. So what I do is start, come from right to left. I put my comb in. I don't ever go in like that. You don't want to take off this bulb because you want the pomp to sit down low. So you come in and you pull your comb out at about a 45 degree angle. Take off the lens, come in, take off the lens. And then what I like to do is just to get the little tiny hairs, I just come up ever so slightly, just flip them the little bits of hairs, just off there. And if you still feel like it's sitting a bit heavy, then you're more welcome to take a little bit more off. But I'm probably going to take off just another half inch. Use my T outliners. They're American. They've got the America converter on them. You can pick them up from Larry the Barber Man on Instagram. So what I'm going to do now is head down for me slightly. I'm just going to go with my... I'm literally just going to take up to here. And what this will do is this will get it to... 0.01, get it to pretty much skin, and then I'm just gonna go around them edges. I'm gonna use my Andis foil shavers. You can buy these from Sally's or Barber Blades. They come with a T-blade head, like the T outliners. They're just the British version of them, but you can just detach the head, quite simple, and then you can just reattach the head. I can never reattach the head. There you go, you can just reattach the head like that. It's real simple to take on and off. So head down from slightly, Jay. What you do is you don't need to push down on these really hard. You literally just float these across the head. They'll do all the work. You literally don't need to do any of the work. As you can see, I'm not pressing it in tight. I'm just floating it just on the skin slightly. So we're gonna be getting out that skin to half. So you go on a zero grade on any clipper, and you just flick that out. Same as what you would do to get a half out of a one, or a one into a two, or whatever you're doing. It's all about the flicking out instead of sort of using, and you can use your grade to go a little bit higher just to get them little marks out. You go back to lower. You see where Jay's hair, he's got a slight little overlap where he likes his hair to be sort of shaped up and edged round. So what we're going to do is we're just going to shape that up. So what we need to do is we need to come. Usually, because the camera's not here, I would stand in front of Jay and I would literally do it nice and straight. Pulling it down. We're going to stick in the hard part. So what I'm going to do is I always start from front to back. I never ever start from back to front, because from the front you know where you can go back. Always put your line in first as well, and always make sure the hair is really wet, just because if there's dry bits it tends to flop down. I don't ever like to do my hard lines too fat or thick. I like to do them quite, so they look more natural. I'm going to take length off of Jay's hair, because obviously Jay's hair at the minute is really floppy and long. So what we want to do is we want to take off enough length so it gives it that hold and it gives it that to sort of come back and lean on itself, so it goes into a sort of pomp sort of style. I like my pomps to be about, I don't know, 4 or 5 inches. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take off of inches. Right, so what I'm going to be using now, I'm going to be using my Bluebeard's cutthroat. As you can see, it's a lot thicker, a lot heavier, it's a bit more weighty, it's solid. It is the best cutthroat in Britain on the market, I can guarantee it. So now what I'm going to be doing, I'm just going to be edging day out. Ah, I forgot my pro line. So well, I never ever forget my pro line. So I'll be using pro line. You can pick this up from pretty much anywhere. You literally spray from afar. Don't ever spray like that. It's pointless. Always spray, cover the eyes. Just mist over. Same with the back, mist over. Come around, do this side. Razor, literally the tiniest bit, do not go into the hair, literally you're just shaking the razor on to the line. Just be careful. I say be careful because I've genuinely seen people slip. I've genuinely seen people cut in their parts because it's such a small area to razor. People tend to often sort of cut people more in this area. So just be careful. So what I'm using now is, before we get onto the styling, I'm going to be putting in Superhold Spritz hairspray. It's holding, it's a mousse kind of spray. Spray it in, comb it through. Spray it. Make sure the hair's wet when you when you comb it in. I'm just going to spray the hair down slightly again before I start drying. Camera. Right, so what I'm going to be using on Jay's hair, I'm going to be using Uppercut Featherweight. It's a really light product, it wears quite dry to be fair. I need the tiniest bit. I say tiny, that looks loads. I need the tiniest bit. Rub it into your hands first. and just roll it through the hair. And what you do is you get a wide tooth comb.
So this is the 360 angle of my haircut. I hope you enjoyed my video. Please like and subscribe and give me a thumbs up. I love thumbs up. I love seeing them thumbs. Thank you for watching, guys. I really, really appreciate every single one of you.